Your sin runs deep, your grace is more. Grace is found, is where you are. Where you are, Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me.
Good morning. Brother Randy Swisher, would you stand, please? Randy Swisher, would you stand, please? This is Brother Randy. He's in charge of some missions efforts this summer, particularly to New Mexico and New Hampshire. After the service, if you are interested in either of those missions efforts, please see him in the foyer, right? All right, information desk. Thank you, Brother Randy. Also, Brother Walter Creighton wanted me to just say that I need to remind you that today is the last regular day to sign up in person for the pictorial directory at the table right outside in front of the information desk where Randy Swisher will be after the service. You can continue to register online, but let's be honest, some of you, it's better to sign up in person. And so take advantage of that, and that'll be outside in the foyer just after this. Amen. Now, there's a foyer, and there's a bulletin. There's a lot to see in there, particularly on the last Sunday of this month. I'm working with Brother Rick Hedrick, and maybe we're going to have a baptism out in the lake on the evening of Memorial Day weekend on Sunday night. So if you need to be baptized, that's mentioned in here. You need to send me a note. You show up the day of and say, hey, preacher, I need to be baptized. It ain't happening. Okay? We need to have a discussion before then about baptism. If that's you, you let me know, and we'll confirm that date later on. And also earlier in that afternoon, we'll mention these over again throughout the month, but that afternoon we'll have an open house at our mission house. If you didn't know that your church had a mission house where we have missionaries from time to time and Christian workers stay, then keep that in mind for the afternoon of May the 28th. So there's a lot of things to keep track of. Stick this in your Bible, but not where you're not going to see it again until next Sunday. Put it somewhere where you probably will see it, maybe on the fridge. We all know that the fridge door gets lots of action during the week, and so maybe put it there. Why don't we stand and welcome one another to the service today?
What's that?
It's Carly's tattoo, real.
Yes.
Was I supposed to wear my prom dress?
Did anybody else wear theirs? Maybe that's a...
And then Jacob and his girlfriend did.
I don't see where he wore that.
Bria's parents are here and Blake's here. Riley's here. Riley didn't wear his.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. Would you be free from your passion and pride? There's power in the blood. Much whiter than snow. There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Sin stains are lost in its life-giving flow. There's wonderful power in the blood. Would you do service to Jesus, your King? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you live daily?
How he healed.
Ushers, come. Everyone else be seated. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Amen. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Amen. Shouting is God's idea. Amen. And some, I fear, will have to attend worship orientation when we get to heaven. What will you do when you get to heaven and there's no book to hold? You'll have to find something else to do with your hands. Yeah. It's God's idea. God's idea. Psalm 47:1, oh, clap your hands, all you people. 1 Timothy 2:8, I would that all men pray, lifting up holy hands without malice and without doubting. Lifting our hands, clapping our hands is God's idea. It's God's idea. You say, I can't play nothing. I can play the juice harp. You can clap your hands. You can't even play the spoons. You can clap your hands. The Lord is worthy. If I was in school and I thought I had the answer to a question, you know what I do? I raise my hand. I know the answer, so I raise my hands. I've been told in martial arts that if you want to surrender, you raise your hand. I want to surrender to the king, so I raise my hand. I'm told in the book of Lamentations chapter 5 that we lift our hearts to the Lord. When I want to lift my heart to the Lord, I lift my hands. Brothers and sisters, it is God's idea. It's wonderful. And all that talk about there's power in the blood, we don't sing that because Grandmammy did. We sing that because it's the Apostle Peter's idea. 1 Peter 1:18, for as much as you know that you are not redeemed with silver and gold and corruptible things, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a lamb without blemish and without spot. It's the Apostle Paul's idea, Acts 20:28, and feed the flock of God over which the Holy Ghost hath made you overseers, whom the Lord has purchased with his own blood. It is God's idea. This is God's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. Jeremy, why don't you stand and let everyone see who they're supposed to see for a second. That's Jeremy Brock. He's starting a new workout program called Spinners. I'm just kidding. We've got on Tuesday night, we have basketball over here from 6 to 8. On Tuesday nights, it's for men ages 12 and above. You say, what if you're a female? Then I guess Tuesday night is not for you, right? What if I'm 11? I'm almost 12. Tuesday night is not for you. I'm sorry. And so thank you, Brother Jeremy. You'll be here at 6 then, right? Opening up with a round, spherical, orange, rubbery, maybe leather thing that he'll toss through the hoop. And it's a time for fellowship. And so if you're not any good at it, it might be a great reason to come out. But Jeremy is the Shaquille O'Neal of Sandy Ridge, and so he'll be out Tuesday. Thank you, brother. Who has a guest they'd like to introduce? Okay, go ahead, Greg, and then I'll follow you, and then we'll let someone else do. Go ahead. Thank you very much. Jeff and Angela Hillen, would you stand, please? Barbara, Jeff and Barbara Hillen, would you stand? We had two Hillen families where we came from, and I always get them mixed up. And then Daniel's with them, and Micah is in the chair to the right of Barbara, and in between is Brooklyn. And they were in Fayetteville at the church we ministered at, and they've moved to Wilkesboro since then. And that's 47 minutes away, as you know, so it's probably, although I'd love for them to come every Sunday, it's probably something they should try to do second or third choice. If you have a loved one that has a church in Wilkesboro, would you see them after the service? Thanks for being here. You've made my morning very special. Thank you. Now, if it's a church your loved one doesn't go to but once a year, that means they don't like the church. Don't send them there. You know, if your loved one says the preacher's a bore, why would you send my friends there, right? So, or the music's awful, don't send my friends there. So if you have a loved one or a friend that has a church that they enjoy enough to go more than Christmas and Easter, please see my friends and help them out. Anyone else have a guest they'd like to introduce? In town, out of town, first time, returning visitor, whatever, a guest. Okay, well then let's pray. Father, we are your people. And the sheep of your pasture. Everything we have is yours. Everything we are is because of you. Everything we've done this week is because you gave us strength. You've brought us back together one more week closer to your kingdom. I pray that you'd bless this offering, the fruit of the labor that your people have worked this last week. The oxygen that you've given us to keep pastors on staff, to pay utility bills, to keep buildings looking nice, to send the gospel around the world through our missions work. This is work that you have done. Our benevolence for our members, all of that made possible because of the sacrifices of your people. Lord, please receive our offering, both in resources and in worship, and in the preaching of the word to follow. In this building, we have heartache over loss. We have heartache over separation. We have heartache. We have heavy hearts over those who are going to be going into the next phase of their lives as graduates. And it's a big world and they're concerned. Would you grant to them the assurance that the grace of God is sufficient? Would you help them to realize that the grace that saved them is the grace that will keep them? Would you build in them right here and now a confidence that the good God and Savior, Jesus Christ, will be with them every step of the way? We know you've heard our prayer. I pray for those who are regularly infirmed and not able to be with us today. We ask you to keep safe those who are traveling. Thank you for allowing Brother Homer to be here today. I pray that you'd heal my brother Rick here with his recent back injury. And Lord, I think of those ladies in here who come without their husbands. Week after week, how strong they are in the faith. Thank you for their testimonies in their households. I think of men who are making hard choices of leadership in their homes, and they use the Word of God, and they listen to the Holy Spirit, and week after week, they bring their families. Thank you for their leadership. Thank you for all of the volunteers all week long that make this church what it is for you. Would you, O Lord, continue to make your name famous here? Would you continue to make your name famous here until you're coming? We ask you these things in the most worthy name of Jesus. Amen.
I saw the crowd laughing and walking as he slowly walked down the street. I saw the man carrying the cross on his back as it fell many times at his feet. They beat him and they pierced him till the blood flowed from his side. As he slowly turned his face toward me, for the first time I looked into his eyes, and I saw
What a song. It's almost insulting to comment on it afterwards. That was wonderful. Praise God. Let's look at Mark chapter 3 together. Thank you very much, singers, musicians. Okay, so we have a medical emergency. If you are not medical personnel, let's not go to the foyer. There's plenty of folks back there. We don't need any sightseers back there. So if you're not medical personnel, let's just pray. Lord, we need you today. Sometimes medical emergencies don't wait. And I pray that you'd be with Bonnie Jenkins right now. I pray that you'd be with her family. I pray you'd be with Danny. I pray that you'd bring healing right away. Everyone's praying. Lord, this has not caught you by surprise. You are not reactionary.
Amen.
We know that you've got this situation in hand. I pray that you'd strengthen our hearts and minds. I pray that you would address both situations. I pray that you'd be out there and that you'd be in here.